Okay, hi everyone. Welcome to my presentation. My name is Billy Setiawan. I'm a PhD candidate in applied linguistics at the University of South Australia. Today I'll be presenting developing intercultural competence through language learning from a multilingual and intercultural perspective, self-reflection on a language learning diary. My presentation is divided into a few sections. First of all, I'll be sharing with you the aim and the context of the study. Next, I'll be explaining the theoretical underpinning of the study, which are the intercultural in foreign language education, and an overview of various studies. It will be then followed by the methodology sections, which is about the data collection and data analysis. After that, I'll be sharing with you the findings of the study, and I will end my presentation with conclusion and recommendations. So the aim of the study is to critically explore the contribution of foreign language learning, in particular through self-reflection on a language learning diary, to the development of one's intercultural competence that is pertinent in today's multilingual and multicultural society. A diary was written during the German language program I attended at the University of Manchester. It was part of foreign language learning for intercultural competence course that I took when I was completing a master's degree in intercultural communication there. One of the objectives of the course is to contribute to society through the development of a sense of civic responsibility in the students by emphasizing the importance of intercultural communicative competence for successful interactions between and among different cultures. So this is relevant to the theme of the conference, which is about the value of languages in multicultural society. And I myself speak multiple languages. Indonesian is my native language. I also speak English and some local dialects in Indonesia. And a few years ago, I started learning German. And the study is based on this theoretical underpinning, in particular, the shift of the goal of foreign language education these days. Traditionally, foreign language education focused on lexis, syntax, grammar, and translation only. It was also highlighted that in many language classrooms, language was treated as context-free and a static body of knowledge. However, a more communication-focused approach emerged after the 1960s. Himes, for example, stated that language learners should develop not only grammatical knowledge of the sentences, but also the appropriacy to the context. Through systemic functional linguistics, Halliday also emphasized the importance of learning meanings in communication other than just the linguistic forms. And from this, several communicative competence models loomed, such as of Kanal and Swain in the 1980s. And since then, communicative language teaching, or CLT, has become very influential in language education around the world. In practice, however, CLT has been criticized for situating communication and meaning within a monolingual context only. Communication model in the native speaker context is deemed the most relevant and applicable in any community across the globe. On the other hand, globalization has insisted mobility of people from various linguistic and cultural knowledge. People bring diverse information, ideas, technologies, and financial resources inside and outside the classroom, blending together diverse linguistic and cultural capitals. Thus, communication occurs across languages and cultures among people from diverse linguistic and cultural backgrounds. It has prompted reconsideration of the nature of goals in foreign language learning. It can be suggested that foreign language teaching should also equip students with skills to communicate with people from various linguistic and cultural backgrounds, and it should be seen from a multilingual perspective. It can also be argued that through the lens of culture, students interpret, construct, and communicate meanings in the interactions with teachers, peers, texts, and other resources in the classroom. This seems applicable to today's multilingual and multicultural society, where people from different languages and cultures communicate with each other. This has also urged the need to consider an intercultural perspective in foreign language education. So what is the intercultural in language teaching and learning? An intercultural perspective or an intercultural orientation in foreign language education recognizes students' multiple languages and cultures that are brought into the classroom. It acknowledges that meanings are subjective to the individuals, or in this case to the students, and shaped by individuals' interpretation of their linguistic and cultural capitals. All in all, learning languages from an intercultural perspective takes into account the students' multilingual and multicultural repertoires that reflect their day-to-day life in today's diverse world. Anthony Lidicote and Angela Scarino, for example, propose five principles for learning languages within an intercultural perspective. First, through active construction, learners come to understand that language learning process acknowledges how language and culture relate to each other. Through continuous reflection, learners develop ability to monitor and evaluate their learning, along with understanding of how language affect cultures and vice versa. Second, learners also make connections between what they have already known, for example, their language and culture, and the new language and culture they're learning. Learners identify similarities and differences between the existing and the new, and relate the old to the new in an attempt to make learning relevant and meaningful to their life. So learning languages is both intracultural and intercultural. Third, through interactions with teachers, peers, and texts, learners continuously negotiate and make meanings across languages and cultures by interpreting their own and others' frameworks. And next, through reflection on the encounters with languages and cultures, learners become aware of how they think, of how they know, and how they learn about languages, cultures, and the relationship between, and also about concepts such as diversity and identity. The reflection affects both their affective and cognitive learning, and it also allows learners to dissenter from their own frameworks and see things from a new or others' perspective. And last, through responsibility and willingness to develop intercultural awareness and sensitivity over time, learners participate in being in diversity, not only acknowledging diversity through numbers, but also living, acting, and respecting other participants in diversity. So the five principles summarized here place language learners in the worlds of diversity, that is multilingual and multicultural, and also represent today's society. The question is, how can we capture such principles from students' perspectives? Noonan and Bailey stated that through a language learning diary, students could provide record of their feelings, emotion, perception, strategies, and interpretation of their learning experience. Chow also explained that diary entries could capture students' affective, cognitive, and instructional elements that shape students' learning. And according to Borg, journal or diary writing allows the authors, in this case the students, to reflect on, generate, explore, and discover ideas. For researchers, diary entries give access to participant voices and sometimes hidden views. This could provide better understanding of the subject. Considering the benefits of diary data for both the author and researcher, my roles in the study are both as the author and also as the researcher. And next, I'm going to explain the research method. I kept a diary during a German language class that I attended for one semester. It was 10 weeks in total, and the diary captured my encounters with language and culture through text and interactions with peers and the tutor. And the diary entries were stored in an online storage. I used Google Drive at the time, and I also used the diary template provided by the course. And to capture the developments of my intercultural competence from the start of the program to the end, I initially aimed to analyze the first entry in week one, and then entry four, middle of the program, and then the last entry in week 10. In practice, however, I also included entry two and entry three because they captured the focus of the study, which is the multilingual and intercultural perspective in language learning. And then from the entries, I identified some keywords and emerging themes. I then relate them and analyze them based on the five principles of an intercultural perspective summarized in the previous sections. I also noticed some few limitations in this study. First of all, the diary was maintained as a requirement for my master's degree course. Thus, the content might heavily be based on my understanding of what I learned in the course, in the program. The study is also interpretive in nature from the intercultural lens that I've been studying. And it was taken back in 2015. I realized it may not be recent anymore, but I believe that it still represents foreign language classroom these days and still relevant to the multicultural world today. And moving on to the analysis, the first finding that I got from the study is about the pronoun systems and addressing people in different culture. As we can see here, the entry one was able to capture my feeling. For example, it was interesting for me to see different pronoun and politeness system between my own cultural framework, which is Indonesian, and the other's framework, in this case, in German pronoun system. The diary captured my reflection on my own culture. For example, in the entry I wrote, I guess it will not be appropriate in my culture, in our culture and language, we will never. So, and with regards to the principle of active construction, I was able to reflect on German pronoun system and how it relates to the conception of addressing people and politeness among Germans. So I was able to see the connection between language and culture and about how language affect cultures and vice versa. And with regards to the making connection principle, I was able to make a connection between my own framework of addressing people and politeness in my own culture to the new one in the German system. And the next one is about the discussion of alcohol in education. It was taken from entry 2. As we can see here, the entry was able to capture my emotion. For example, I was a bit surprised to see discussion of alcohol in the textbook. I then reflected on my own cultural framework. For example, in my country, we will never include some alcohol in education. And the diary entry was also able to capture my initial perception. It is seen very negative, but I developed curiosity. I am wondering, and interestingly, in week 10 or the last week of the program, in entry 10, the diary was able to capture the change or the shift of my perception with regards to discussion of alcohol in education. And the diary entry was able to capture my acceptance of differences and also a shift or change of my attitudes. For example, here I wrote, it didn't come as a big surprise anymore because I understood it may be different in different cultures. And it captured the openness to different practices in different cultures. I realized that what might be inappropriate in my culture should not be understood the same way by others. So I became aware of my own ideological perspectives and values and also others' values and perspectives. And with regards to the principle of reflection, I was able to recenter from my own cultural framework and see things from different perspectives. And the next one is about a student tardiness and the tutor's considerations of differences. So entry one in week one also captured my observation of other people's emotions and their knowledge of other culture. In this example, I noticed one of my classmates, he was being very regretful and apologetic for coming late, knowing that in German culture, most people like to be punctual. So the entry captured my observation and also how the tutors manages some differences in the multilingual and multicultural context. So this entry allowed me to not only observe my own intercultural competence, but also to reflect on others' attitudes towards diversity and differences in a multilingual and multicultural environments. Thus, it has become a great asset for my intercultural journey. And then the last one, N33, I was able to capture my observation of other people's behavior, perceptions, and feeling. And it also enables me to decenter from my own perspective. For example, here, seeing my classmates struggle understanding the lesson or the content in the lesson, I wrote, I understand from her perspectives, and then I was able to build empathy toward others. I was triggered to help my classmates, encourage her, and try to be a friend. So this showed how I lived, acted, and respected others in being in diversity, which relate to the principle of responsibility. And to conclude, the diary was able to capture my emotions, feelings, perceptions, interpretation, and attitudes toward language, culture, and its relationship in language learning. The reflective writing allows me to look back to my own linguistic and cultural values, explore the new language and culture I'm learning, and then seek out the gap in between to mediate. The experiences, observation, and reflections captured in the diary seem relevant to be applied in today's multilingual and multicultural society in order for the people in the society to live and act accordingly and respect other participants in being in diversity. And from this, it could be recommended that language education should involve reflectivity and reflexivity that will allow learners to reflect on what it means for them to be in diversity. It can be accomplished through several ways. For instance, language teachers, through mediation, should encourage learners to notice, compare, and reflect their own and others' language and culture. And tasks and assessments, such as language learning diaries, can also be powerful to allow students to explore their reflectivity and reflexivity. So I think that's all from me. Thank you very much for your attention, and I welcome any questions or comments. Thank you very much.